8 lines of coke later. Okay, yeah, we gotta try it. Alright, so I can definitely see why this is a co-op board. Oof!
Corey! What have they done to you, buddy? Oh, God! I'll save you.
Hello, Baron. And Cybermank. Baron and Cybermank, they're a team. They fight crime. Oh, my God! Oof! Corey, why didn't you warn me?
I'm getting knocked down. Knocking up again. Yeah, I'm gonna take me to hell with you. Without my consent.
Why would I complain about a damage increase? I don't know, because it's backwards day or something. Classic room door to the very old part of the facility. Oh boy. Yeah. Oh yeah! Nice! Yeah. Oh yeah! Nice! Nice! Oh, this gives me the happies. Like, well done. Well done. Like, I've seen people that, like, will mix, like, the classic stuff with the modern stuff and, like, not really explain why it's there, but you just did it like the secrets from the campaign. I have all the respect in the world for that. That's super awesome. Love it. Love it. This is so cool. Right, the pinkies are tougher in this board again for some weird reason. All right, nice. Whoa, did I just get imped? Oh. Okay, I feel like I got turned around here somehow. All the way back here? Was there a. Okay. Oh, I am so confused. All right. This way. Yep, through the... Oh, at least it's still playing the cool classic music that I like. So that might be something to think about here. I'm not sure, what's going on there, but with the okay, this way. This is probably the first case where the checkpoint system has kind of gone a little wonky, and I'm just sort of taking a long walk of shame here. I mean, you're damn straight I'm going to go back and, like, see if I can... I earned this secret, doggone it. Earned it. I'm going to finish it out. Right. Yeah. Okay. What's that? Oh my God. Oh my God. This is the very model of... Well, you know what? It's not mandatory. It's a secret. If I didn't want to be here, I wouldn't be here, so... No complaining! Yeah! There we go! Alright, there's another one over there somewhere. I gotta be careful. Says to you. Ah, spit at you. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Good. Okay, so, alright, let's move up and ever further into this craziness here. It's awesome. Alright. Oh! Walk of shame time again. Alright. Oh, no, we don't want to go that... Oh! Because that was the checkpoint. Okay. So, at the very least, now I know that when I... when I do decide to start stop faffing about with the secrets and start doing the actual thing, that at least I'm not going to be taking such a long walk of shame this time around. Oh! There we go. High ground, bitches! I didn't want the static rifle! Nobody ever wants the static rifle! Oh, jeez. Oh, three? There is three of them? Oh, my goodness. Oh, man. This better unlock a cinematic of Doom Guy getting a blowjob. Holy cow. But, you know, I am bound to determine at this point. We are seeing this through. I want to see the end of the secret. Yeah, I don't care if the time is red. You know what? Time can be all red all at once. I don't freaking care. So, yeah, that answers my question. There is apparently a part time of 30 minutes. I don't know if that was, like, an actual, like, you must complete it in this time to be considered a winner kind of thing going on, but according to the red blinky in the up, or the red time up in the upper left of my screen, I'm taking longer than I'm supposed to. But again, hand me a secret section of content, and then damage increased by 50%. Nice. All right. Well, that's a good reward. That's an awesome reward. Awesome. Okay. Good. I got a damage bump. Now let's go back and kick the rest of this board's behind. Doggone. Oh, I need more health. Okay. There we go. Maxed out. Do 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 do. Do I am Doom Guy? I'm gonna kick your fat butt. Oh, man. Okay. And I do believe this was the way to go. Okay. Okay. I don't want the static rifle. Oh, wow. Dude. Not cool. Not cool. Alright. Grabs the plasma rifle. There we go. Yeah. Yeah. So I'm getting a little more of the hang of the way the Tesla rocket works, although remembering that I had the stun mod, like, in the heat of the moment was also good. I know this room. Alright. Oh, come on. This was not a good place to be. Oh, well. Oh, well, dang it. Doggone. Alright, so that was to the left, right? Let's finish this area out first before we... Okay. Yeah. Okay, so on a personal level, I do have to make a confession, which is that I'm starting to feel a little numb to the combat. It's sort of the same issue we were running into with the board I played previously, where, like, I liked running into the secret earlier. That definitely freshened things up a bit, but then the... So here we are back to just sort of this, which is, you know, I'm going to die a lot, you know, probably. I mean, don't get me wrong, still having some fun here, but, I mean, it's definitely, I'm getting worn down a little bit to the spectacle, I think. Just a bit of enemy overload thing going on. And of course, it doesn't help that, like I said, I played another big bad spam board right before this one, so. Alright, so there might be a thing over here. There is a thing over here. What did that do for me? I have no idea. I whatever, I found a secret. Yay me, I'm doing pretty good on secret finding today. That's sort of one of my little trouble areas. Corpse 9 has seen better days. Okay. So I take it this is corpses 1 through 3? Yes? I can't have these weapons? Okay. Doggone. Alright, well. So, I guess that's 1, 2, 3. And then, I'm gonna guess we're gonna see some more corpse piles along the way. Is this okay, I'm engaged again. I'm engaged again. Let's give it credit for that. Because now I've got a whole new little secret to unravel. I still didn't figure out. I just realized there was a puzzle involving Lego pieces or something at the beginning that I never really sussed out. I'm just remembering that now. Do not want. But yeah, now I'm like, okay, so something's going on with the corpses and the number 9, so I'm guessing there's going to be 3 groups of 3. That's my hypothesis. Going forward. It's a big smarty sounding word. Great. So I can camouflage my dummitude. Alright, is there... this feels like there might be a thing back here. There sort of... there's an opening, so I kind of want to think there's something in there. But I have a feeling I'm not going to be given enough breathing space to figure it out until after I do something about... El Dumbass Brigade here. Go through the steps, buddy. Yeah. Okay, so... Oh, this... Okay, yep. It's another BFG ammo. And I, again, did not take the class that has the BFG, so... Well, dang. Okay. Oh, Corey, I wish you could have come forward and seen all of this. This feels like a gank moment, so I'm going to guess maybe your corpse 4? 5, 6, 7... I don't know. One of you corpses ain't had a good day is all I know about the situation, so... I don't know how many of you count as the corpse I'm supposed to be counting to. Alright, so... Reactivate the teleporter. Checkpoint is reached. Grab the thingamahoozit. There is a Zerk that just popped up, so... Let's just go ahead and have some fun here. Rawr! Yeah. Oh, no you don't. You get back down here. Oh, you son of a... Think you've escaped your fate? No, you have only made it worse. Because now it just won't be a simple shot to the head. No, I gotta think up something creative to do to you. Oh, I know. How about... Yeah. How about you be the first person to die to this static rifle I have no idea how to use. Slow, painful-like. Oh my god, taking forever, isn't it? Yeah, that sucks. And on top of it all, I do that. You have died in electric pain. That is your punishment. Could have had it easy. You could have been killed by the Berserk, nice and quick-like, but no. No, you had to do it that way. All right, so we're back here. I'm still... I don't know if those guys count towards the Corpse 9 count thing. Did I come over here yet? Did I fully examine everything that could possibly be over here? Yeah, I think I did. Okay, so there's a teleporter that's now active somewhere. Okay. Still curious about the Corpse 9 thing here. Are you talking about Corpse 9 from outer space? Alright, no. No. Oh wait, didn't this, split? Yeah, this split into, a weird T-junction. Maybe there's something over here now. Oh, hey guys. Hello. How you doing? Oh my goodness, another one of you dudes. Yeah, this feels like one of those maps you're supposed to go back and replay after you kind of figure things out the first time. And, you know, and also, like I said, this is definitely a have a friend with you kind of map. A lot of this combat definitely feels like it's as intense as it is specifically because it was meant to be enjoyed as a two-player experience. But you know me, I'm such a... Yeah, just gonna chill on the floor with my little rah-rah. Alright, are you, he had a BFG and he died? Freaking what? Well, okay. We probably couldn't find the ammo for it. Oh, what's this? It's a thing. Alright. Alright, so what killed the guy with the BFG in this... Oh, wow, okay. Alright, and you are... The Baron of Hell. Tim. Tim the Baron of Hell. Alright, so I'm observing that shooting you makes you take damage. Good. We're off to a good start. I can come up here and refill things. Ooh, quad damage. Do I want to grab that now, or... Because I'm getting this feeling that... Yep, Bruce Berserker and Black Baz, Black Blaze. Ooh, I've played a Black... No, I haven't. So, okay, so these guys are sort of side mini-bosses. So, and that happened when Tim was down to, probably 66, 75%, I want to say, is when that got activated. Okay, so this is Bruzerker. Then Black Blaze is the Revenant. I think I'm doing alright so far. I got a lot more room to move, so that's helpful. And, Tim is sort of helping me out, which is cool. Oh! Nope! Tan pasted. Okay. Next. Well, yeah, you may have had a BFG, but I have functional immortality, so there. Alright. Low on the ammos. Shouldn't be a problem. I have plenty of it sitting around. Don't worry, quad damage. I see ya. Okay, so actually, he's down to 27%, so. There we go. Oh, there's no shotgun ammo in here, or did I just eat it all? Okay. Didn't I already power the teleporter? Ah, whatever. Okay, so I want to say this was the boss battle, so. And server room. Oh. We're in the computer room. We're in the computer room. Oh, the tele... Okay, so it's one of the panels in here. Oh, I gotta go all the... What I'm seeing. 4, 3, 2, 1. So it should be over here. Oh, here we go. Power relay 1 activated. Okay. Oh, music's rocking out again. Power relay 2. Alright. So that turns on the power for the teleporter. And... Victory! Hell awaits! Off we go! Oh my god, 55,725 points, and we averted a Cretan moment. Yeah, all right, we're definitely voting that up for a multitude of reasons. Co-op and single player and survival. I feel like what I want to do is... I wanted to actually change single player to hard, because I think as a co-op board, that would have been a very difficult one. I just want to see the leaderboard real quick. Hey, all right. I did pretty good, apparently. Okay, so I'm happy with that. Real quick, I just want to go over like the things with that map. Now, that was a very fun map. It had some puzzles hidden in it, which I love. It had, you know, a little bit of humor going on with it. It had a bit of a narrative structure. It was definitely designed for co-op, and I like the concept with the separate classes. So you kind of get to, you're basically sort of picking a loadout as you go in, and that's pretty cool. One of the downsides, I think, to this approach, and it's something I've discussed before, which is when you have just one battle after another that's just, you know, oh, a bunch of cyber mancubuses and a bunch of barons of hell and stuff like that, what ends up happening is by the time you get to the end and it's like, oh, here comes Tim, and it's like the impact of seeing a baron of hell, you know, you don't really get that pants pooping moment anymore, because it's like, okay, you're only the 12th, 13th baron of hell that I've come across. Now, you know, it was good that on the way into the room there was that setup with the, oh man, he had a BFG and he still died. I mean, that was good, because it, you know, there's only so many, one of the things that I'm perfectly aware of is there's only so many resources to work with in SNAPMAPS, and you know, so it's not like, you know, but that's one of the reasons why you want to kind of show a little restraint with the with using like the big bads like the Cybermank and the Baron of Hell. You know, you can sort of overt that and get around that by what you can do is you can just sort of take some of the other existing mobs that don't get used quite as much and just adjust their damages to kind of increase your difficulty that way without overkilling your big bads, you know, so that you have that you have that punchy impact at the end when it's like, so the boss is a unique mob that doesn't show up anywhere else in the map. That's sort of one way to do that. You know, these are, again, though, minor nitpicks here, are just things that I do feel like I have to bring up, because it's like, you know, as I play, you know, and it's like I said, when, by the time you run into like your seventh or eighth Cybermank, the impact, it loses a little bit of its spice. You know, it's like when you eat a really spicy taco, you know, those first couple of bites are super spicy, but then, you know, after you eat about four or five of these super spicy tacos, that fifth taco doesn't seem as spicy as the first taco, you know, because you're just, your mouth is so inundated with spice. So it's sort of the same thing when you overkill the big bads. So, you know, just, it's just something to think about. But, you know, it doesn't take away from the fact that this was a great board to play. I think it would probably be a whole lot better if I was playing this co-op. You know, it does feel like the combat was all designed to be enjoyed with a friend, and I enjoyed the humor of it. I enjoyed the humor, definitely, like, played along with the player a little bit, you know, which is fun. You know, I like that it felt like I was being engaged, you know, by the structure of it. And also, super kudos for having that little side mission in the classic map. That was great. I really enjoyed that. I felt it was just well hidden enough so that only people who'd be looking for it would find it, you know, and then, you know, you get a cool thing for sticking it out. And that was cool. It was like a little mini encounter scenario in itself. Kudos to that. So Spunky117 did a great job on Co-op Classic Warfare. That's map ID KUN6 AEVE. And I'm going to go ahead and say this is one of those co-op maps where it's actually worth it to hang out in the lobby for a little while and see if you can get someone else to connect up with your game before playing it. Definitely worth it. I enjoyed this one. Game over. Game over. Game over. Game over. Game over.